Yeah, thanks, Mike. Nice bit of delegation, that. Give the new chum the bum job, eh? I get the obligatory opening joke again. I mean, really, Phillip Island, spectacular Phillip Island. Raw physical beauty, the legendary penguin parade, the attractive little hamlet of cows, and my first professional responsibility is to take the mickey out of it. I suppose I could do that old chestnut what's brown and comes out of cows backwards, answer the Phillip Island ferry, but that would be tasteless and rude. Now, I think the only real joke down here is the aforementioned penguins. I mean, penguins. Fairy penguins. I thought they'd be big penguins, you know, 4 foot high, the kind that can kick your dunny down, the sort you've seen David Attenborough poncing about with in the bloody Antarctic. But no, these are teeny-weeny disappointments of penguins. I mean, half the population of Osaka comes down here in buses every damn day to see penguins, and all they get is these minuscule little birdies. Mind you, they're damn fine eating.
Oh, Dunga, what does it really taste like?
Penguin?
Yes.
Sort of like a cross between koala and dolphin, actually. Have a bite, go on. Here's some in here. Health food of a nation. Iceland.
I think we've successfully insulted everyone, all the viewers, to get us started today. Well, Alan Moffat, yesterday we mentioned that Peter Brock was fast time. Right. On a Sunday morning, of course, the Peter Jackson Dash determines where they start in the main event. And this morning, Peter Brock was hoping to pull position number one out of the bin. He didn't. He went to John Bauer.
Peter Brock has drawn position five. John, position number one. That's the way it goes. You're not going to complain.
Well, it's my justice, mate, after Simmons Plains, but, obviously, I'm happy about it.
Obviously, everyone is very tight. Three Fords, three Holdens in the top six. It should be fantastic.
Well, it's a great circuit, and, all the top guys are very much on the pace, so it should be really good racing.
So, cars out on the track at the moment, warming up those tyres. Let's take a look how they line up for the Peter Jackson Dash after the draw this morning. John Bauer. Bad luck in Tasmania. Good luck today. He's on pole for the Dash with a 1:34.75 qualifying time yesterday. And Alan Jones has moved up from the back row to start on the outside of the front row. Row number two, made up of Glenn Seaton and the Peter Jackson Falcon on the inside. Mark Scaife and the Winfield Commodore on the outside. And Peter Brock, 51st career pole yesterday, counts for very little. He's back to five, and his teammate Thomas Mazera should keep him good company. I don't know where the pace car is going to turn. Yes, it will turn just past the pits here and get them away to a good start. Go! Racing! Bauer the winner. Over the crest and down the hill. Bauer's trying to protect the line. And look at Scaife moving across. He's trying to work out who's got the fast line to the turn. But Jones! Around the outside. Scaife picks up Seaton, dismisses him, moves to third as they head down into the left-hander. Beautiful.
They're making some demon starts recently and really got the hammer down there. Glenn Seaton, his team leader, left a long way behind, but Alan Jones will lead them round for the first time.
Fords 1-2, Commodore 3.
John Bauer looked as if he had the start. In fact, he did. He was first across the line, but Alan Jones, a wonderful move on the outside to go flying through turn one and leading here now as they go down towards the ocean.
Well, the suggestion, Peter Brock using a very soft tyre for the Dash this morning. He'll be trying to get around the outside of Glenn Seaton and maybe pull up a spot. We arrive at the STP race cam. Glenn Seaton, as they go beneath the Shell Bridge, order has unchanged. Alan Jones. Car sounds beautiful this morning. John Bauer back in second. Mark Scaife would like to split the pair of them. Glenn Seaton sits in behind Scaife. And then it's Peter Brock over Thomas Mazera.
Very cold temperatures of Phillip Island today. Strong wind blowing across the circuit. Forecast of rain. Everyone locking up their brakes. I think everything will be pretty cold out the circuit at the moment.
A bit too cold, Mark. Most of them have got the brake ducts taped off to stop the air going through to the duct. But you saw Glenn Seaton there lock one up.
This is where the race is for third. Now has Seaton got another mumbo jumbo to pull to the outside here and try and pass Scaife down the straight. Look at the speed difference, the Commodore. And there's Brocky hounding the pair of them as they come across the line. One down, Seaton. Thought about an inside run down here. Scaife protects that line. He'll be forced to go the outside.
Looks like Glenn's copped a missile on the screen there. Big crack across his laminated screen. It comes right under the wing of the Winfield Commodore.
He's seeing a wide Commodore there at the moment, but Mark Scaife holding him off at the moment.
Out of the southern loop. Work their way back toward Honda Corner. It's very close here. Peter Brock, tyres working very well in the 05 Commodore. He comes right up behind Seaton. Thomas Mazera rounds out the six, so it's Jones still holding control over John Bauer. Scaife, Glenn Seaton coming under increasing pressure from the Holden Racing Team Commodores, Peter Brock and Thomas Mazera.
He misses a gear as we take the Glenn Seaton car. This will show you what's going on behind there. Wow. Losing right, looking for an inside pass here as they exit that turn. Through the seven sports sweeper now. So Jones has been able to drift away from John and Bow. There's the gap. So AJ giving his PJ team some hope here at Phillip Island. I would think Glenn Seaton would be horribly disappointed. He did start in the second row and had a chance there at Scaife, and he's drifted well back behind Scaife. Maybe just protecting the tyres, who knows?
He could be at this stage. He's still going to get a good starting position, Mike, and every lap is going to count here for the two heats. Tyres must be used in the dash, qualified yesterday, used in the dash, and in the two heats.
Well, they're coming up now to the final corner, and it'll be Alan Jones, the Peter Jackson Falcon, out to five car lengths as he swings through here. The wide open spaces now of the front straight at Phillip Island, with the checkered flag ready to unfurl. Payday for AJ as he gets it across the line. Second to Bow, third to Scaife, fourth to Seaton, fifth to Brock, and sixth to Thomas Mazera. Let's check the map for you on the Shell race score. Alan Jones, the winner over John Bow. Mark Scaife finished back in third. Glenn Seaton was fourth. And Peter Brock rounded out the five. Back at Phillip Island in just a moment. Number 30, John Bow alongside. And just a little earlier, our own AJ caught up with AJ.
Alan Jones, the Ford, obviously likes the Phillip Island track. Are we finally going to see the Falcon flag fly today?
Well, I for one sincerely hope so. Andy, the car is well suited around here. This is where Glenn does most of his testing, so I guess if we don't go well here, we'll never go well anywhere.
Everyone's talking about the tyre wall. You've got the Bridgestones on. How are you situated?
Well, pretty good. We've chosen some fairly hard ones because it was sunny yesterday, believe it or not, and we've really chosen some very hard tyres, and I was actually worried about getting temperature into them for the three-lap dash, but they were very good.
They were good. I'm not quite sure whether you'll get enough temperature into them at the moment, because it is quite cool here at Phillip Island.